Hello everyone, a while ago I found out about a new medium and I was very intrigued and I kept on hearing about it here and there, watching art videos or reading art books, and I didn't really, you know, I didn't want to try something new and I thought maybe I will try one of these days, but I just, you know, put it on the back burner. And then as I kept on hearing more and more about it for some reason, I thought I should give it a shot. It intrigued me. I saw a lot of really cool artwork done with it. So I thought it was time to give it a shot. So this new medium is called Casein. And when I say new medium, it really is very old. It actually is way older than oil paint. And casein is actually the name of a milk protein. And that's what this paint is made of. So it's a water-based paint. And it's very similar to gouache. It's opaque, and you can dilute it with water, obviously, because it's water-based. And you can make it as light as watercolor, so you can pretty much use it like watercolor if you want to. Just like gouache, you can do the same with that. But you can also make it very opaque, again, just like gouache. And so because I've started painting more and more with gouache, I really wanted to try. I was very excited about it, so I took opportunity of a little trip to the art supply store, and I was a very good girl. I only bought three colors, a white, titanium white, Payne's gray, because I wanted to try this new medium with just like a very limited palette, and I wanted to start with monochromatic paintings. And I also wanted a yellow ochre because I read that casein is really nice for underpaintings as well. So I got a yellow ochre because that's a color I like for my underpaintings. Now when I swatched them, I realized the Payne's gray had a lot more blue in it than I'm used to. I was hoping for a blue gray, but it's more like a blue. So it's a really beautiful blue. I really like it. But, you know, that's what I had to deal with. So I made swatches, I played with it, I diluted it with water. And you can either dilute it with water to get lighter colors or mix it with white. And I like the effect with white better because it's not as grainy as with diluted with water. So when I started painting my little studies, this is what I did. I started my first layer with diluted paint just to start establishing the values, and then pretty fast I started just mixing it with white and building up the contrast with either the Payne's gray with the white or by itself. Because I had so much fun with my first little spoon, I ended up painting two more, the exact same ones, and I mixed my Payne's gray with my yellow ochre, and I was happy to see a nice green, almost like a gray, and I really like this color. And then finally the last spoon I did with the yellow ochre by itself, and the white of course. So it was a nice little exercise that helped me get familiar with this paint, and I absolutely love it. I must say that I find that one of the main differences between casein and gouache would be that casein doesn't move with water as much once it's dry. The pigments will move a bit with water once they dry, but not very much. So that's really neat to add the extra layers on top of it. And it dries really fast, so you can actually work pretty fast with it. So I had the same fun as using gouache, but maybe not as much frustration, because even when gouache is dry, as soon as you add more water, then you have to be extremely careful, otherwise all your layers will blend and melt under your brush. And I didn't find this happening very much with casein, so I really, really enjoyed using it. And the more diluted your layer is, the more water resistant it becomes. And I believe that even if you have a thicker layer, over time, as the paint cures even more, it becomes even more water resistant. So what I learned about casein is that unless you're using very light layers like I did in my sketchbook, if you work with thicker layers, it's much better to use a hard surface like a panel, for instance. If you want to use a canvas, you got to make sure that your paint is not too thick, because otherwise it might crack over time. But right now I'm only using it for studies and to get more familiar with it. And I must admit that I liked it so much that I had to order more colors because I want to play more with this. So even though I was a good girl the first time around, I ended up getting more colors. Kind of knew this would happen, but you know, sometimes you never know. You might get something and you don't like how it works, or you can't figure it out. And it's good to just have a few colors. Plus it's easier to work with a limited amount of colors. So that's what I did. I loved it, and now I'm gonna play some more. If you have any questions about casein, don't hesitate to ask. I'll do my best to answer, although I'm pretty new to the medium. I've read a bit about it, so I'm getting more and more familiar with it. All right, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this new medium. Well, new to me. And you like my little spoons. I had a lot of fun painting them. And I think I'm going to paint more, because I don't think I've ever painted spoons before. And I don't know why. Maybe I'll start painting forks as well. Thank you all for stopping by. If you like this video, remember to put a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you soon in another video. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.